Hi again. It's the next day after making the, or whatever day it was for those two cells. I think it was yesterday. So we're at 15 minutes and we've been charging on 2.8 volts and we're at 150 milliamps still and going down. I topped them up with a little bit of electrolyte just on the edges. And I was thinking I might have to pull the cells apart because I found some foam which doesn't dissolve in acetone. So you know what happened? While I was making a new separator sheet, this one's a manganese dioxide. It's got 10 grams coated in there, bit of wastage still. Both sides are coated. While I was doing that, I decided to soak the bit of foam. Still wet, as you can see, it's gonna take a while to dry out. Hopefully it keeps its form, but there's 4 grams of manganese dioxide and cellulose acetate in this sponge. So that might solve some of the, hold some more electrolyte perhaps. I don't know how it's gonna go. It's one of the, just a theory. So I'm gonna use the carbon I made the other day and the manganese dioxide carbon as a double carbon cell with two different carbons. I checked the resistance on the other sheet, the manganese one, and it's 2K, where this one's 15K. So that's got activated something in it. Yeah, and we're going to do a time lapse of the cell after 17 minutes charge at 2.8 volts connected in parallel. That's the two double carbon cells with the motor, just for going out sake for the cell. Alright, I'll connect it up and I'll be back. Okay, made it to 12 minutes. Still running, but we wouldn't call that really running. Alright, so that's it for those cells, I think. Or I make a zinc. I have one carbon graphite plate left, so I could do a zinc version. Then later on, if they die, might do that. I'll keep them around, see if they last out in the open for a while. Alright. Hi there, we're going to try another double, two types of carbon coated onto paper towel in membrane. This one is the homemade carbon we used the other day, and this is the manganese dioxide carbon. And as a weight comparison, that's the homemade carbon, 0.5 grams, and that one's 1.1 gram, and the membrane, I've got one, plain coated membranes, around about 0.2, how does that work, is that one lighter? Oh no, that was 5. So it's about 3 grams, 0.3, that one. And that one would be about under 1. The sponge one hasn't dried yet, so that might be tomorrow's cell. It's the same electrolyte. I've got two, I've got the homemade carbon on the left side and manganese dioxide carbon coated paper towel on that side here in the same electrolyte, but I added an extra gram of zinc sulfate. So I'll put these cells away. And for the plates, one's a zinc plate and a carbon graphite electrode. I ran out of these, only got 5. So that will be the cell size. Alright, the homemade carbon's going down onto the zinc first. They've only been soaking for 5 minutes or so. Put the manganese dioxide one on top. We'll rotate the pattern so the pattern of the material is different. That'll stop it from going inside. Add some more electrolyte just in case. Copper collector again for the carbon side. Okay, we'll connect it up. I wonder what sort of result we'll get. Oh, voltage is higher. Oh, it's the zinc plate, I think. The reason why that is. And short circuit. Oh, 160 milliamps holding, well, dropping now. Well, that's not too bad. I'll turn on that power supply and we'll give it some charge. Okay, that's about a minute at 2.77, and we're about 2 volts. And we'll see what the data logger's got to say. I'm on 30 milliamp load, cutoff voltage 0.49. We're holding 2.4 volts stable. Wow, just changed the material slightly. I'm really, really liking the idea of painting the cells on stuff. Wow. Oh, hang on, this might not even be working. Yeah, alright. Oh yeah. Is it connected? Well, I thought I was. Device stopped. Alright, we're connected now. That was weird. Alright, so it's not so fantastic. Okay. 4.9. It's probably glitching out again. It's too warm. I think when it's hot, it starts glitching out. I'm sweating big time. What is the temperature in here? 31. That's the wall. So tomorrow is going to be the day. 43 degrees. I don't think battery. Oh, batteries maybe in the morning. Alright, here we go for a test. It's been sitting uncharged for a bit then. Not bad for a 1 minute charge, but it did have a short circuit of, what was it, 160 or something, with nothing just put together. I should keep it upright so the electrolyte don't leak out. So the whole sheet of the manganese dioxide has about 12 grams or something. It's quite heavy compared to the homemade one. And a lot, if you can sort of see the floppiness to the not floppiness. Thin coat, multi coat. I multi coated it, so I let it dry, coated it again until the solution ran out, both sides. So that one little cell matches those two cells connected. But they're the same type of carbons on each pad, which you'd probably expect that to be. Oh, first time we got our 1 minute charge back on a run. These last cells, sort of the charge is longer than the run time. Well, we'll have to deplete that one because it had power. This one surely probably wouldn't run like this again the second time. Never know. That's showing that putting it on the paper towel is much better than just when we did it in the solution and just painted it on the cell. Probably because it stays in place. Or the extra gram in that solution, perhaps. Oh, no, hang on, I'll check that if it was a gram. It was one of these spoons what come with the zinc sulfate. Yeah, it says 1 gram. To do a 15 minute charge on this one. It may cook it. Alright, I'll let that run and I'll get back. Okay, back at 26 minutes and we're at 14 milliwatt hours. We're probably not going to get too much more. That was a minute's charge, but fresh cell. So we'll stop there. And voltage bounced back pretty well just then. So I'll start a 15 minute charge. Okay. Starting the charge, and we're on. Might drop the voltage. 2.4 volts and 143 point something milliamps. I'll be back in 15 minutes. Well, it's 17 minutes and it's still at 148, so I don't know, let's have a look. Don't know what's going on there, and that should be dropping. It's holding. Okay, disconnecting the charge. Oh yeah, it dropped, so it's working. Alright, attempting a run. I think the voltage is leaking. No, it's not going to run for us now. Yes, it is. So we got to beat 13 milliwatts, milliwatt hours. That's what it did the first run, I think it was. I think we're somewhat lower in the wattage. Could be dry already. I have two more soaking, so we'll layer them up later after this test or another test. By the looks of it, might need another test at 15 minutes. It's quite warm here though today. Just add some electrolyte on the side. Not much. Not noticeable, nothing happened. 1.35 on the multimeter. Still holding in there. Alright, I'll let that one run and I'll get back. Okay, that's the second time we got, oh, we're 14 milliwatt hours, but we're 27 minutes instead of 26, and slightly down. So that's twice. I'm gonna, while that's been waiting, I've had the two other carbons soaking in the solution for about 20, 30 minutes, and basing them. So they should have a lot more electrolyte in them. And I'll put them in. So we should get 28 milliamps maybe. I mean milliwatt. That's wet still. Yeah, there's tons of liquid in there. Alright, that's the plain carbon. Add another plain carbon. Put the fins the opposite way. All the markings on the tail. New piece of manganese dioxide. The original. Carbon plate. Electrode. And clamp. Okay, for a short circuit. Now we've doubled up the cell pretty much. 125 milliamps, holding 0.3 volts. We can run the little motor. Not too bad. Alright, I'll give this one 15 to 17 minutes on the same charge, connecting the charge. 2.3 volts and 150 milliamps. Alright, we'll see if that's down this time. So there's plenty of electrolyte, and now I might put some on the top layer just so it's so hot in here. Not much. Well, I know why they made these things. These work really great for putting little bits of liquid down. Oh, start the timer. I'll see you in 15 minutes. Okay, we're at 83. It somewhat went down this time, and 2.5677. And we're at 17 minutes, milliamps. Okay, so we'll stop the timer. So we got 13 milliamps, 26 to 27 milliamps last run. Alright, I'll disconnect the charge. Yep, the voltage is live on the thing. 2.1 and 2.1, they're sort of matching. Oh, and it's sort of somewhat holding. Alright. We'll start the test. This is double the layers. We'll try a slightly longer charge after this, a half hour charge I think may be okay for this cell. So that would be convenient if it does have double the power by just adding an extra layer. That's a clean in construction wise and pretty neat. Oh, that's probably how they do the caps anyway, on that membrane. They coat both sides and roll it up. Done. Okay, nothing new. It's holding its voltage not too bad for one single cell. I think they're 50 by 50s, the carbon cells. Close. Or 50, no, 40 by 50. Might be more like it. Oh, I can't believe the carbon foam thing still hasn't dried. It's spongy, I don't want to poke it. It's somewhat getting there, you can hear it now. Still spongy, it's firming up though. It might collapse when you press it in areas. But we'll see. 4 grams of manganese dioxide on that, or embedded in that. With the acetate membrane. Well, we're at 3 milliwatt hours at 2 minutes. 1.7 volts. Well, that's an impressive little cell. Okay, I'll let this do its thing and I'll get back. Hi there. It's at 36 milliwatt hours at the moment, and it's been running for 1 hour, and we're still at 0.9 volts on 15 minute charge. This thing's like supercell. We're trying out a half hour charge after this one. So the voltage held for around about 30 minutes above 1 volt. That's my personal record. It's going to be all depressing after this cell, because none of my carbons would probably match it. But a good base level indicator. Well, it's got one side of my carbons on it, and it's only around about 2.6 grams of material. And then most, it's only this, I don't know, if the plates are bigger than the collectors. That's a carbon pad, if that matters. Probably is all working as one still. So around about 2.6 grams, say 3. It's not that great, I don't think, but it's pretty good for my cells. One step ahead. Alright, till it runs out. It's way too hot to do a time lapse. My phone will melt. It's melting now, and it's only been nearly two minutes. Well, that was quite impressive. It's an hour and 42 minutes and 52 milliwatt hours, and we're at 0.5 volts. That's not too bad for that little cell just sitting up there. It is manganese dioxide, but the other side's got my home brewed carbon. So that could be helping, maybe. Find out when we substitute that for activated charcoal. So I'm gonna try another a half hour charge on the cell. I'll dab some electrolyte around the outside and let it absorb in. I'll do that now. So the voltage increases, it's because of the electrolytes going on now. It's actually quite warm in here. It's 38°C. And we're holding 0.509. It's actually held pretty good there, between 31 minutes and an hour and 12. Okay, so we'll stop that. So we got for 15 minutes we got 52 milliwatt hours. We got to beat that one on a half hour charge. I'll write that down, I'll forget. 52 watt hours, 15 minutes, charge, in an hour. Alright. Let's see what it bounces back to. Probably won't go much. Oh, yeah. I'll connect the charge. It's the same charge. I'll turn the meters on first. Right, connecting charge. The voltage should increase on screen now. Oh, no, it won't, because it's not on. Right, turn it on. Here we go. There we go. We got 2.2 on the multimeter and 2 up there. And 168 milliamps. Down to 164 now. Oh, better get the timer going. Alright, I'll be back in half hour. 5 minutes overdue for the time charge. We're at 105 milliamps on the dial. 2.5 volts. So, first half hour charge for this cell. Last one was 1 hour and 44, 52 milliwatt hours. Alright, so that's how time we have to beat. Alright, disconnecting the charge. There we go. We got sitting at 2 so far. Starting the test. Cell looks pretty damp. I'm gonna try another layer sometime in this cell as well. I'm not sure if it was dropping this quick in the last one or not. Half hour could be a bit overkill for it. Still quite warm in here. Still 38.1. What's the cell's temp? Cell's 34. That's a sun-facing wall. I'll get back when that one runs its course. Oh, sort of missed it. It's for a half hour charge, it only went for 1 hour and 11 minutes and delivered 37 milliwatt volts. I mean, milliamp hours, milliwatt hours. I'll get it right. Bounced back though. I don't know what time it actually stopped. I just got in here. So we'll see. We'll do another quick run without a charge. They were considerably down. The other run for 15 minute charge was 52 milliwatt hours. So it seems that I've got still a bit of power hanging out. So now I gotta try it again with a 15 minute charge. See what it gets. Connecting it to the charger. Milliamps. It's 2.28 on the charge and 170 milliamps and decreasing. Alright, so I'll get back in 15 and see what sort of run we get then. It's only, I think this would be the third charge really. one 15 minute one, one half hour one, and this 15 minute one. Alright, till then. Well, quick look at the cell. I think it's wet enough by the looks of it. But that's on the outside only. Hopefully it would draw moisture in as it dries. Only a minute in. Okay, on the ball this time, we got the timer right. We're still at 111. It is decreasing, but slower. And 2.48 volts, so that might be topping off at the cell where it starts not decreasing in milliampage. It's only a guess. Alright, we got to 15 minutes. Okay, let's see if it does as good as it did the first time or what we had the last time. Alright, disconnecting the charge. We've seen it in another cell though when we overcharge it. The smaller charge for some reason has more power. I think it's dropping somewhat quicker. Still looks pretty wet, the cell. Alright, I'll let that do its thing. Fingers crossed. It's holding up quite well. It's 19 minutes, still at 1.2 volts. That's a good sign. The other ones were holding over one volt for 30 minutes at least. This one may just make it, depends on how long it's holding. Seems to be holding good. Just dropped by two then. Okay, it's seems to be down in power. Just cut off then. We did 55 minutes. And only 29 milliwatt hours. So I'll increase the charge voltage slightly and we'll do another 15 minutes. Because the cell is pretty wet, still, unless the plates are oxidizing. Tomorrow I'm going to try the carbon, double carbon in this setup, get rid of the zinc plate. So we might as well, what voltage, we'll connect the charger now. And it's 2.2, we'll go up a bit higher. Alright, we'll go for that. Oh, went down again. Alright, we'll do 15 minutes at 2.5 volts. Milliamps off the scale. Back in 15. Okay, coming up to our 15 minutes. On 2.7 volts. Disconnecting. Okay, we're somewhat holding. That was a high voltage charge for 15 minutes. Okay, we get 1 minute and we're still at 1.9, we've done better. Not even, I think it was less. It was probably at 0.7 for a minute last run. Doesn't look like electrolyte solution issues. It's pretty damp. I even squirted a little bit on there just then. So the two averages around about probably 28 milliwatt hours for that current cell. Okay, I'll get back in a while. Okay, somewhat missed that one. 44 minutes on that one, so we're down again by 10 minutes and 23 milliwatt hours. So we drop every time we charge, maybe. Well, that's it for today. I'll pull it apart tomorrow and we'll film that and see if we'd stick some electrolyte. And give it another 15 minute charge and see how it goes there, and then we'll swap it over to double carbon pads. Alright, till then. Well, we made it to the next day. This is the first charge on a 1 day old carbon and zinc cell. It's a manganese dioxide one layer and homemade carbon on the other layer. After this test, we're going to add another two sheets, so that will be three in there. We're at the moment, we're averaging around about 25 milliwatt hours on 15 minute charge. The cell sort of doesn't do a half hour charge. The energy is down, well, we're not quite sure on that, but we've hit our 15 minutes today. Okay, disconnecting the charger. Ah, good, the volts went down there. It's got 30 milliamps as a load and cutoff voltage is 0.49 volts. Starting the test, day two. So we should get about half hour at 1 volt. And after that, it just drops right off, sort of. It's somewhat dried out last night. It's been pretty warm. It's, forecast today to be 43. It's 9 o'clock and we're 29.5 degrees C already. So we'll try to get all this done before lunchtime, but these here need to be soaked for an hour. Actually, 24 hours would be better. The ones we used yesterday weren't quite absorbed any of the electrolyte. I'll just add some more on the pad. The stronger the electrolyte solution, it's starting to form crystals around the cell now, where the 1 molar doesn't. The other electrolyte's still too sloppy. After the other test, we'll put some of that, when we add the extra plates, we'll test it and then see how it goes, and we'll add some extra carbon just to hold some electrolyte in the solution. So it still looks like it's okay. Alright, I'll let that run and get back. Okay, we've dropped in voltage heaps. We're not even at 30 minutes and we're down to 0.8 the day after. So, that'll be enough for that. So we got 15 milliwatt hours in that time. And for the meters, we're at 1.2 on a recovery. I did notice that the load will actually run after a run on that data logger somewhat. It ran better this morning actually, without even a charge. So we'll pull the cell apart and see what's going on. Okay, we spilt some electrolyte under there again. Still pretty wet under there, so we're not out of electrolyte. Maybe just this crusty stuff's blocking. I'll get some sandpaper. I'm surprised there's that much electrolyte. Can you see that on that cell? So that's wet, so that's not the issue. They're wet in layer. That's the two manganese dioxide ones, and that's the side what was down. That's wet. These are the two homebrew carbons. And that plate's alright. Manganese dioxide maybe ran out. There is a film, but it's not as bad as that cell the other day. It's quite clean actually. Oh, I'll put some electrolyte on there. Put the other carbon piece in. That's the homebrew carbon. So now we've got three pieces of carbon. This is the third piece of manganese dioxide carbon. And the other two. So that's effectively lifted our cell to 3.9 grams of material now. I think it's 1.3. Or just two sheets of the carbon. So I'm wondering what part has actually degraded. There was no physical damage. That plate under there is quite clean. Okay, righto, so we'll do a short circuit. We're at 100 milliamps. We'll put in some voltage. Okay, that's about 20 seconds. We'll let it settle down a bit. And we'll give it a short circuit. 180 topped. Runs the load. So it's not drying out. Could be that copper pad, maybe, when I was adding electrolyte around the sides, gone under. Perhaps. I've given it a clean, so we'll charge it up on 2.7 volts. It's gone over 200 milliamps at the moment for 15 minutes again. Alright, we're down now. We're lowering pretty quickly. Alright, I'll get back in 15 and see if we've improved the capacity of the cell by adding that and giving it a clean. Okay, we're at 15 minutes. And that seems to be oscillating now. Or taking a very long time to decrease. It goes up as well and then drops and up. So, we'll stop the timer. So this one's a bit of a mystery because there doesn't seem to be any drying out, but we're losing power. Oops. Well, I bought that. That was a false touch. The power supply is still connected. Alright, disconnect the power supply. Crooky. Alright, we're down, we're dropping, that looks good. We're 2.11 on the multimeter. And 2.16 there. Alright, doing a correct test. Alright, we're working. Okay, we're holding the 2 volts now again. May have been just the electrode on the end of the graphite sheet gunked up. But we added that extra new piece of manganese dioxide, which might be it. So we'll see if we get 2 runs and then it starts dropping off again. We know you can consume the manganese dioxide pretty quick. I suspect it's the copper contact. I'm surprised also that the zinc plate wasn't all gunked up. Nothing was actually etched into the surface of that zinc. You could wipe it clean with just a rag. So we did have, what was it? Oh, I've forgotten now how much milligrams. It was 1.3 for 1. 2.6, 3.9 grams should be in the cell now. So now it's actually looking okay again. So, alright, I'll leave it at that and get back. Okay, adding that extra manganese and the carbon may have changed it. It's 1 hour and 37 minutes. and 45 milliwatt hours. We're down at 0.5 volts. We probably won't get much more, so we can stop the experiment there. And I'll give it another charge for a half hour this time, like we did last time, and check the power density then. And then I'm gonna turn it into an all carbon, with a carbon, get rid of the zinc plate, and put a piece of carbon on it. Okay, that's our charge voltage, 2.3 there, and 2.7 on the multimeter. Oh yeah, we're going up a little bit. It's doing over 200 milliamps. Alright, I'll set the timer. Alright, I'll get back in half hour. Alright, we're coming up to our 30 minute charge. We're still at about 210 or 219 milliamps on the amp meter, and the voltage is 3. So it's made it up to 3 volts. Let's see what this 2.7 on here. Alright, disconnecting the charge. 2.09 and 2.1. Alright, same 30 milliamps, cutoff voltage 0.49, starting test. Strong smell, but it's warming up really quickly. It's only 34 at the moment. 12:58. Yeah, hottest spot was the window at 35. Seems to be holding okay. It's got to do over 1 volt for a half hour or it's really declining. Maybe it was that copper collector. Got some aluminium I could use. That might be worse. The cell looks still pretty wet on the edges. It's holding okay. This time it's holding at some voltage more. Perhaps it was the electrolyte getting under the collector again. Alright, so I'll add no electrolyte. Yeah, the carbon foam thing, that's dry. Somewhat out of shape though. Sort of spongier there, thick where it's collapsed and stuck together. The binder could be too thick for it. Doesn't come off on your fingers. There was 4 grams, but there's some stuck around the outside, I don't know, probably 2 grams there. So that might be an interesting one. Laptop's starting to heat up a bit. Wonder what the temperature is. 44 on the poor laptop. Oh, 48 there. I might turn it off for an hour or two. So this thing should, I'll make the cell first and then add the electrolyte afterwards, or it's just going to be a big mess if we fill it up at that size. I'll have to put a separator on one side of this, I think, because it's not like the paper one. This would be considered probably one electrode or one piece of active material. It's pretty dark, it absorbs the light, doesn't it? I've noticed with the carbons. You put a torch in there and you somewhat can't still see. Oh, get right up, you can see it. Anything of interest? Alright, ran out of memory. I forgot we filmed most of the day yesterday. I'm deciding I'm going to keep this cell intact how it is, and later on when it dries a little bit I'll pull the collector off and tape it with some electrical tape after cleaning and drying it, so that seals it and the electrolyte shouldn't be a problem in that area. That should fix that issue. And We're 30 minutes in and we're still at 1 volt and 25 milliwatt hours. So now the cell's doing what it did originally. Pretty much. So it's halfway down, so it will get the 50 milliwatt hours again, I guess. Only guessing. And it's really, really warming up, so this will be the last test for a bit, because the laptop's... Oh, it's cooled down, actually. 43, or was it only... I don't know, I think it was 45 or something, maybe not. 35, that wall. 42 on the laptop there. 43 there. Scan it. The cell's 36, 35 degrees. Oh. Little data log is 35. I'll get back with another update. It's probably going to run for another hour just to make everything get so hot. Alright, somewhat of an improvement, sort of. We've got our 50 milliwatt hours. Sorry. And 1 hour and 42. I think the very first run was 1 hour and 44 and 52 milliwatt hours at the same, but we'll do it again. Won't be testing it today. I'll end the video because this one's like a whole day yesterday and a little bit today. And keep that cell alive, and I'll construct the other cells out of those other two carbon cells I made before. So not too bad. It's an interesting cell. And that's all right. Thanks for watching.